Tina Mitchell here, your local mortgage expert and your host of Coffee with a Superstar. My show is with real estate agents for real estate agents. I interview the best of the best in the industry so that you can hear what they're doing and how they're doing it. Each week I travel to my superstar's office to invite you behind the scenes of their business. And this morning my superstar is Rizwan Awan with Compass Real Estate. And Riz, thank you so much for joining me this morning.
Yeah, pleasure is all mine.
And a little bit about Riz. Superstar, the definition of a superstar is somebody that's doing a lot of volume in our local market. And definitely Riz is. He closed around 58 transactions last year. So not too bad for a real estate agent, right? A little bit more about Riz. He is one of the promising real estate agents that aims at providing the best service for his customers. He deals with all of the issues involved in real estate transactions, ranking from buying or selling real estate, works with foreclosures as well. Rizwan wants to redefine the real estate experience for his clients. He is fully aware of the stress and tension that can be faced by you in making decisions about buying and selling. Rizwan wants to change this dreadful experience into one of the most memorable experiences for his clients. His objective is to take a pleasure journey with you while undergoing a kind of transaction related to real estate. So Riz, again, thank you so much for being here this morning. And I always like to start out and ask, what do you credit your success to?
Yeah, what do we credit our success to? I mean, there's a lot of things, but especially last year, or being in this business for about 12 to 13 years, I would say continuing education. Uh-huh. I keep educating yourself on the changes in the market. Now, when I'm talking about changes in the market, it could be the rules in the MLS forms. It could be changes in marketing, changes on way you can generate leads. So keep on educating yourself on how you can keep taking your business to the next level. I think that definitely pre-planning, planning and having a schedule. I know a lot of people say having a schedule, and they have a schedule, but it's in their brain. When I started putting it down, actually, it was actually a game changer for me.
Yes.
You know, I put a schedule down, and now I'm scheduling like 9 p.m. the day before.
Uh-huh.
So I kind of put it down, and I have try to spend 80% of the time on productivity stuff. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? Yeah. This thing that we're going to generate new business.
Yes.
So that's the main thing. So I try to come into the office, go straight to the prospecting desk, and just go in and just prospect, you know,
yes,
for the good amount of hours. And we get pretty busy sometimes, and then it's easy to let go of your schedule. I think you have to control your schedule, and you have to say, okay, from 10 to 11, I'm going to look at email. I don't even have transaction emails on my cell phone.
Yes.
So I don't even go in there. So yeah. I have a dedicated hour to, you know, turn off, you know, take out fires.
Yes.
You would say.
And I love that. And I love to hear that from you as not only a real estate agent, but a high producing real estate agent. Little shout out, Riz has gone through my program, One Time Your Business, 8-Week Burn. The link will be posted, 15 clock hours for real estate agents. So Riz knows exactly how I feel about time blocking, and definitely on the same line. It is critically important that you time block your day. And I know you're going to hear from majority, especially in the real estate agent or in this real estate space, that you cannot do it. You can. And it's critically important for you to be able to take control of your business so that you can have control over the process and everything that's happening. So it's so important to stick through that. And you're hearing it from a top real estate agent that he actually just credited his success partly in due to that. I also like about the 80-20 and really putting 80% of your efforts in production, because as a real estate agent, you can get really wrapped up into the process. Riz doesn't do this all on his own. That's another key indicator of a superstar, somebody that's producing at a high level. They're not doing it on your own. You heard it, the transaction emails don't even come to his email. So really being able to manage and staying focused on the high level activities, and what's most important is bringing in the business. And then your team manages the business,
yes,
and the process of that. Is that correct?
That's correct, yeah.
Yeah.
Delegation and having team.
Yes.
So I think a lot of people say, hey, I have a team. So, oh, a team doesn't really mean you got 20 buyer's agents and you're providing them lead. A team is to have a good transaction coordinator,
yes,
a good marketing person, someone that can take care of you know, your clients when they come in. So that's a good team to me, is your core.
The core is the other, yeah, the buyer's agents, they come after you have the structure of the team in Pross. And yeah, we actually have Riz's marketing guy. We've got Victoria behind the camera, and then Guy is actually taking some still photos of us as well. So Riz has an identical team to what I do. Now, Riz also talked about education, which is really important in the process. There's a lot of continued changes in the process, whether it's in the environment, it's the economy, it's the product, the service that you're providing, new technology, and all of that. And so staying at the top of all of those changes is critically important. And it also helps with your confidence in being able to walk the walk when you know exactly what's happening on the education level, correct?
Yeah. So let's say you're, you know, educating yourself could be becoming better on dealing with for sale by owners. It doesn't have to be an education. You got to set up and read a book. But how do you approach a for sale by owner, for example? A lot of people won't do it because they don't know what to say. They get still. They lose their chain of thought. So maybe you can educate yourself in the process. Like, what do you do when you go meet the for sale by owner? What do you do when then you come back to your office? What are your steps? You know, so you can do that. Again, educate yourself on how to have a proper buyer interview when you're meeting with the buyer, if there's someone you want to work with or not. At a certain level, you will know which clients you want to work with and which ones you don't want to, so that they can fit you and your life better.
Yeah, and so again, in the education, 80% of his time being in the producing new business, you want to be able to educate yourself on how to best get that business and to close the business so you can have a higher closing ratio, because that's what it's all about, correct?
Yes, for sure.
So Riz, what about a recent or not so recent challenge that you've had to deal with in your business, and how did you overcome that challenge?
So I'm going to refer back to you know, a book that I read. It was called Man Up. It was by a gentleman named Pedro Escolian. And he talks about the crop duster and F-16 fighter. Like how their day is different. Like the crop duster might just go in his plane, doesn't just go in crops, you know, puts the dust over the crops. While you got an F-16 fire jet fighter, like a pilot, he goes in and he has a checklist of things he's got to do. It's like he's got to check the lights are on, this are on. So same thing with our business. We got to make sure that when we come in, there's a routine that we have. You know, we have to follow that routine. We have to be that fighter jet. You know, we don't want to be a crop duster. So to come in, and for me, there was a challenge. The market got a little bit slow. And when it got slow, it was a little bit challenging because every day you're doing the same thing. You're coming, getting up, you're prospecting, you're calling, and it becomes boring. And it's when you keep on doing the monotonous thing that are boring, you can become better and better at it. And that's when it becomes fun, you know? So for me, that was a big thing. I had to go back to the basics. I had to go back and learn, okay, what am I doing wrong? And get a checklist, get a morning routine. Now the morning routine doesn't have to be like, hey, you're getting up and you're doing 50 things at one time. Maybe you're just getting up, you're stretching out, you're getting your mind ready for the day, you're having a good breakfast. So, I mean, I think these things are very important, that we take those things from personal life into the business life. And that was for me was good, because I got slow for a minute and I have to refocus my mind. And a lot of it was going back to basics, back to focus, back to the first day of real estate and how we generated lead, how we set up those things. So it's important to, you know, have a schedule, I would say again. Yeah. You know, schedule is very important. Having a routine is very important. And don't let go of the basic training that we have. See, a lot of people, they just want to maybe graduate and they're done. But a lot of people go back again and again and take that education and become better and better. And that's what this is all about, going back and becoming better in your scripts, better in your talking tones, better in dealing with clients, better on the phone, better in taking rejections. I'm a big expired and a for sale by owner guy.
Yeah.
So I take rejections all day long.
Yes.
And sometimes that can be pretty dragging, but you just got to get up and keep going. You know, a lot of people come into the industry with having a misconception of what it is to be a real estate agent.
Yeah.
And I think people think, you know, some great agents, they make it look so easy. That everyone
behind the scenes, it's not easy for anybody, right?
No, not at all. You know, we work hard and we work long days, and you have to be prepared for that. And if you are, you'll be fine. If not, you know, 70% failure rate. So.
Yeah. Well, just like any other industry. I mean, there's a smaller percentage that actually are producing, and it's the ones that are working hard. And so if you heard Rizzy, he said it's not about doing 50 things at one time. It's really about being laser focused. And again, setting that schedule and staying consistent on that. What are you going to do from the time that you just literally step out of bed? You're getting ready in the morning before you even leave the house, getting ready and prepared for your day, and then getting into the office and getting ready and committing to what you're going to do. And I love the, you know, the challenge of it. Just kind of gets boring sometimes when you're making those calls. You've got to go through the rejections. I like to, you you know, go through the numbers game. I think really if you're making calls, especially on more of a cold call level, if you can get one of 10 out of that, you have got a really great conversion. And I think if you shoot for that, and when you kind of go for that and you recognize it's going to take 9 failures before you get to the one, it makes it actually kind of fun, because you're kind of rejoicing and waiting for those failures to come so that you can actually, or those no's, so you can get to the yes. And again, you know, sharing about the importance to kind of going back to the beginning, continuing to learn more through that process so you can continue to get better. And it keeps it exciting because you see that, wow, okay, now I've taken it to the next level in the next game, and it's a constant growth, correct?
Yes, yes. Well, sometimes, you know, you don't know really what it means until you put it in practice.
Yes.
You know, and you're doing it and you realize, oh, that's what I'm doing wrong, or this is what I need to change in my tonality. Or,
yes.
I mean, there's so much information out there, but I think you, again, you know, pick 5 things you like to do and work your business around that. I think there's so many ways of generating business in real estate.
Yes, you know? Yes.
I think if you can focus on, my first 2 years, I think I did everything. So I kind of did a little bit open house, a little bit door knocking, because nobody was really guiding you on what to do. The people give you an idea that you can do this, you can do this, but nobody really tells you what to do. Like, so many people want to call expired and cancels, and they really don't know how to do it. They'll call one time and then won't call again. They're scared how they sound on the phone. Oh, what did I say? I mean, the guy didn't even see you, you know, he just heard your voice.
Yes.
So I think a lot of it's mindset and how we talk to ourselves about wanting to do the business, you know.
Yes.
And I think a lot of people get scared and they have the drunken monkey thing, I think it's called.
Yes. Some
people refer to it as a drunken monkey. And the sooner you control your drunken monkey, the sooner you'll enjoy it.
Yes, yeah. And if you prepare, like you obviously do, you talked about scripting and dialogue, you really have to prepare and practice what your message is going to be. And then you have to alter and change that based on the results that you're getting. Because I always say, if you're not getting the results that you want, it's almost always in how you're communicating your message. So you just need to take a step back and play with those words, and you've got to develop a message. My motto is in, or the tip into a great message is a message that's powerful, confident, powerful, and to the point. So you have to feel confident in your message. You have to deliver a powerful message, and it has to be the least amount of words without taking that powerful message away, correct?
Yeah, well, when you have the education portion of it, you are automatically more confident when you're talking to a client.
Exactly.
You know? Oh, what am I going to say next? Oh, hold on. What was that line again? What was that script again? So that's not going to work. But if you're educated about the neighborhood, you know which home, you know, most sellers nowadays know the neighborhoods better than us.
Yeah.
But still, if you can tell them, hey, you know, the appreciation rate this year compared to last year was 6.8%, what does that mean? Yeah, well, last year the average price was 340, now it's 370.
Yes.
So that means $30,000 we're talking about averagely, you know,
yes.
But in your neighborhood. So if you know these data, you know the knowledge, you have the education, you're automatically more confident and you're more to perform better, for sure. Yeah,
so true.
So you have to stay true to the game. You have to go in every day, look at the comps, look what sold, what didn't sell. So,
and have those, you know, the data, like you said, and you can, you know, invest in some great tools that give you data to give comparisons of what's happening now versus what has been happening, the indicators of how markets have changed, and, you know, so really important to have that data. So what about a favorite marketing tip that you would like to share, whether it's experienced agents that are listening that just want to take their business to the next level, or new agents? What is one of your favorite marketing tips?
Well, so again, marketing is such a vague thing, you know, like marketing, just like when you sell someone's seller's home, like what is marketing? So I think, again, it's kind of, who are you marketing to? Are you marketing to your sphere? Are you marketing to an unknown audience? Are you marketing to the buyer leads that are coming in, or is it a seller lead, or are you retargeting them? So it's a pretty, pretty broad description of marketing. But
of
if I was going to give you something, I would say it's definitely stay on top of the new trendy social media that's going on. That's a really great way of connecting with people, multiple people at one time. But never think that you're going to do such a great video marketing that you're never going to have to pick up the phone and eventually call. Because a lot of people get caught up in that, hey, I'm going to do some marketing and I'm doing these cool things. And there's so much noise out there. So maybe you just follow one person that you really like and just follow this one person instead of trying to follow 10, 15 different people and trying to do their thing. Definitely branding, I would say, is one big thing. I believe if you have a brand of yours that you stand behind, like, yes, we are Rizwan Awan and Associates, and we are big on promoting ourselves and our brand and what we stand for.
Yeah.
So I think to differentiate yourself from the other agents out there, branding, I think, is great. Marketing, using social media, using trendy stuff on social media, yeah, I would say, is very big nowadays.
Yes.
But I don't think it's going to, yeah, sometimes it will bring you business. And it's all, again, about having a great team, because I, yeah, can't do all of that myself. So
exactly.
I have an excellent team that
you're doing what I do. You pick up the phone, and you're generating those opportunities. And then the behind the scenes, the social media and the marketing is getting taken care of by the team. And I love how you mentioned it does not take away from picking up the phone, because it doesn't. And it never will. And I really like this time with technology and with social media and video and all of these things, because a lot of your competitors are going to weigh on that to build their business. Not to say that you're not going to get business, but you're not going to get the level of business that you can by picking up the phone. The great thing is you don't have as much competition that are picking up the phone, because there's, yes, so many other ways to be able to make an excuse why not to. So it makes it really exciting if you can really embrace. And I love phone, and it wasn't, yeah, always that way. But I saw the results, and I saw what it could do. That it's my favorite thing. I call it my power hour. And just as Riz, my schedule is very, very time blocked. I know exactly what I'm doing from one second to the next, even from the time block to take to get from a location, like if I'm coming to see one of my superstars. But I have buffer time, and Riz made a mention to email. Email has to be part of your time blocking as well. You don't have your phone and listening to email and just waiting for email and managing it. You've got time block times that you do that. And from two successful industry leaders, one in the mortgage and one in the real estate space, it works. And you can do business without having to be in and out of your email all throughout the day. But buffer time is when I have blocked on my calendar to manage my inbox, and I have a certain time block to do that. And a lot of times I've got more time that's blocked on there, so I have extra time, which is called buffer. And then I get to pick whatever I want to do. Guess what I do every time I have buffer time? I pick up the phone to generate more business, because I know that's what's going to give the biggest results.
Yeah. Well, see, and the schedule thing is this, though. You got to play around with it. It's not like you're going to do it one time and you're going to be like, oh, the perfect schedule.
Yes.
You're going to have the perfect routine. You got to, took me like a couple of years, maybe. You know
but
what
once
I mean?
You did
to put
find
it, together,
it
yeah.
you stuck with it.
Yes, yes.
Correct?
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Now I know what, yes, I want to do. Now how I like it. So, you know, maybe you come into the office and, you know, it's also you got to learn to like the things you kind of dislike,
yes,
doing. You know,
yes.
Like, I didn't like picking up the phone and calling, mm-hmm, but I understood that this is a way that I was going to generate funds to provide the life that I want to have.
Yes.
And so you have to pick up the phone, you got to start calling. And I stumbled quite a bit in the beginning too,
of
you know,
course.
Said the wrong things, but I went back and did it over and over again, mm-hmm, and now I can pick up the phone, I can call confidently, and I can do that, you know.
Yes.
So
yeah,
so definitely you have to keep on doing it. It's no such thing as perfect out there, you know. I don't,
yeah,
care who they are,
nope,
or what they say, but it's never perfect. You got to keep on doing it, and then personalize it, and then just in the end, you will find a routine that works for you.
Yeah, yeah. Like Riz said, you've got to play with it and figure out what works for you. I would encourage you to do the things that you don't want to do first in the morning.
Yeah.
You know, get the most difficult things done first so that you can release any emotional stress you have attached to that you haven't done it.
Yeah.
And there's no pushing things off. If you don't want to dial for dollars, then make that the first thing you do. After you get ready, you've got to get in and structure your day first, email, get that taken care of. But I also want to go back to the branding, because I know a lot of people that really sell their company that they work for, which is great, but I think your company that you work for needs to be secondary to you. You really need to sell your own unique brand. You need to have a brand and an image behind you,
yes,
and what you represent, which Riz is just said, and we've heard from a lot of our superstars. The branding is so important, and it gives you something that's unique about you, and it actually helps you to become the best in your space, because you've got something that you're proud of
yes.
what you represent,
yes.
correct?
Yes.
And people
yes.
want to work, when it comes down to it, it doesn't matter if you're working with your sphere, if you're doing open houses, or you're doing cold calling with expires or for sale by owner, when it comes down to it, you have a connection, which it's all about,
yes.
they really get connected to you,
yeah.
not the company that represents you. Again, that's second to your own personal brand.
Yes, yes. So, you know, it's the companies, you know, they're always going to be that one person that is kind of hung up on the company's name
uh-huh.
or whatnot. But most people, yeah, they're gonna connect with you and they're gonna come through. I mean, I work with, you know, all kinds of companies and, you know, big names, small names, and in the end of the day, they come and work with you because of who you are and your brand. But then also you get a niche. You gotta always have a niche. You know, mm-hmm. people say, hey, I wanna work with everyone. No, that's not how it works, you know? If you can really focus down to who is your niche, what is your niche, and then work it. And then start from there and go. You're not gonna make $1 million one first day, but you know, it's gonna take you some time.
Yes.
And then you're gonna have to keep doing it. And but yeah, definitely branding, I think, is very important nowadays with the social media and everything. And companies are there to help you. And you know, again, then the broker models are changing right now again, but that's a whole different discussion.
Yeah, it's a whole other discussion. But you know, embrace the changes that are happening, because majority of your competition are not going to be able to, and they're going to miss an opportunity. Worse, they're going to get out of the industry. And just like the financial meltdown, we're all still here, those of us that have been through it. And I look at a challenged market or a challenge change in the industry, which as agents you guys are dealing with right now, I look at it as a huge opportunity, because it's a place for me to be able to really embrace that change and to step up from where a majority of my competitors are out. So if you're stressed out about something, trust your competitors are going to be stressed out as well. But the best of the best and the superstars, they're taking it on in full force of how they can take advantage of this, because real estate's not going, real estate agent is not going anywhere. They're going to be here for the long term, but you are only going to be here for the long term as you embrace these constant changes.
Innovation, you have to be staying on top of it. There's always market interrupters that are coming in and doing things. They're going to list you up 1%. They're going to do this. How do you handle these things? Again, education and knowing your stats, knowing your company, knowing how to deal with that particular client. If that's their concern, then that's what you address, right?
Yes.
So, some people are not always going to go for the 1%. They want the best service. They want the best company. They want you to do everything for them, you know? So,
well, just like a car, you're going to buy an inexpensive car that's going to be not provide the quality, or you're going to buy an expensive car that's going to give you what you want. You're same with where you buy your clothes. So nothing's different with service in real estate.
Yes, yes.
And even more so because it's such an important purchase. You just have to show your value.
Yeah. Well, a lot of people do kind of say that, hey, I do provide the best service. But if you do provide the best service, your clients are going to stay there with you for a long time, and they're going to be returning clients. I mean, I would say probably 75% of my business is repeat clients and repeat customers because of what we offer. And we do like to go the extra mile for our clients. Definitely you have to.
Yeah.
It's a part of our business, you know?
What I'm impressed about you, Riz, is you have a high return from your existing clients, but you're still always going out there and building new relationships through the same tools and processes that you did when you first got into the industry.
Yes.
And so I love that, because you have to have a mix of new and old to keep that variety.
So let's say you have, you know, we call them funnels, right? Or you have, like, have you seen those pumps that pump oil? You know what I mean? Those machines?
Yeah.
So same thing. You have a machine, for example, this is your sphere of influence and past clients. That's one way you're working them. Then you have clients coming in from online lead generation, and that's the same funnel you're setting that is providing your funnels. Then you have expired and canceled, for sale by owners, you have online leads. I mean, there's so many different ways, door knockings, and you got to keep them consistent, and that's, you know, they're providing you leads all the time.
Yep.
That's how you keep your running your business. So it's not only just one thing.
Well, you said like five different channels, you know, five different kind of marketing avenues that you're working, and you know, keeping that variety.
It's a lot of work, definitely. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not just as dress nice and go show houses.
Exactly. Anything in life that you're successful takes work. So call to action for the agents that are listening right now when they drop off this. I know you've given a lot of tips and a lot of advice, but what would be a call to action that you would give them?
You know, I would definitely say, you know, align yourself with other agents that are going to help you succeed, or an environment at least. So for some people, it might be that they do need some coaching, maybe. They need a guidance. I would say there's a lot of noise out there. Don't listen to everything. Focus on yourself and your business. And if you can put it on paper, and definitely have goals.
Yeah.
Have small goals. Like, you can't say, I'm going to take 2 listings or 3 listings, but you can definitely make 10 calls a day.
Yeah.
You know? So these are very important things to make small obtainable goals throughout the day, like a weekly goal. Like for me, it would be this week, I know I got to call a certain amount of phone calls, and I'm packing food from home, so you know what I mean? Yes. So that way, this is like other things that you're doing is small, obtainable goals are very, very important. So, you know, get goals, get accountability, surround yourself with a good coach, a good group, and but just only get one or two people that you really like and follow. Don't go after every single one you're listening. Just stay focused on that and focus on your business and your goal, and I think you can do it. You know? It's just staying dedicated to the game and liking the things you don't want to do, like, and enjoy to do those things, like picking up the phones and calling over and over again.
When you get results, it doesn't matter how much you didn't like doing it, you will start like and enjoying doing it because it's getting results, and that's why we're all here.
So one thing that is big for me is I have a big vision board. I'll show it to you later. I have this big vision board and I look at it every day, and it just reminds me that, okay, this is what I gotta do, this is my goals, and I'm gonna go for it, and I have no problem getting on. I stand for like hours.
Yes.
And I just call, has a comfortable shoes on, and there I go, man. I just talk, set up the appointments, and then we go for it. Try to get it very structured. But it took me some time to put it together. It wasn't that it happened overnight. I tried and I failed, and I tried and I failed. Yeah. And I tried again, and I talked to great people. I got great advice. Some of it was great, some of it wasn't. So again, if you can get the right focus group, stay around the right peer, and stay focused to your goals and your own vision board and your, and you'll be fine.
I love that. Riz talked about a lot of noise out there, and there is a lot of noise. So when you're looking for that accountability, as Riz says, you really want to be strategic on who you align yourself with. Yes. They have to be the best of the best. One percentile are killing it. 20% are getting 80% of the business, which they say that that's actually changing to the 90-10 rule. No. So again, majority of people are going to be giving advice and saying things that are not going to serve you at any good level at all. So you need to be really strategic. There's a lot of different ways to get business. So connect with the ones that way that they're doing business is going to work and align with you the way that you want to do business. And then I love one of my mind shifts in one timing your business is rejoicing in your small successes. That's exactly what Riz says. You can't go out and get 3 listings right now, but you can make 10 calls. And those 10 calls, maybe one's going to get to the appointment. And out of those 10 appointments, maybe you're going to get 5, whatever that ratio is of closing those deals. And that's really what it's all about. So great, great advice.
Yeah. And I always do something fun at the end of the day. Like right now I'm planning on taking my son to Disneyland.
Uh-huh.
So that would be the one thing I do in the end of the day. Like, okay, when are we going? What time are we going to go? But I can't do that in the beginning, you know, so I have to wait till everything is done.
Yeah.
And then I'll stay in. So that's every week I have something that I really want to do, but I'll wait. And I'll kind of reward myself.
That is so awesome to have that personal success for yourself at the end of the day based on completing the activities that you committed to yourself that you were going to complete. I love that. We all know that people that budget spend make more money. They have the same amount of money, but if they budget, they don't make more money. They make more out of the money that they have when they budget. And a key thing to budgeting is that you are always saving for something.
Yes.
Something important, because when you're saving, you're going to be less apt to spending money. Kind of the same thing as what Riz is saying here in business. If you have a prize at the end of the day that you get to rejoice and do if you do the goals that you set for yourself to do, you can't help but be successful. It's just a matter of how long it's going to take you to get there, correct?
Yes, yes. And if I can say one thing, I would say we are real estate agents and we should always invest in, we should be our own best clients.
Yeah.
So always invest in real estate, and you know, that's no way around that. You know, we teach people invest in how you can grow wealth through real estate. And I myself was an international student when I came here with no money, no nothing, no contacts, no nothing. And I'll tell you, real estate has been a great way of achieving wealth. And I believe that's a 100% way of the American dream is to do that.
So your first prize for yourself, if you don't already own real estate, is you need to get into real estate.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're a real estate agent, so you need to be investing yourself, but that should be at the top of of your prize.
Buying duplexes, invested in real estate, you know, in income generating real estate.
Yes.
That's what this is about.
You know,
all this servicing people and helping them doing the same.
Of course.
So
that's
one advice I would definitely tell people to start doing for sure.
Well, Riz, thank you so much again for being here with me today. And thank you to all of you that are listening to Coffee with a Superstar. I appreciate you being here and know that the advice that are given from my superstars are great advice, and hopefully it's an inspiration for you to take action in your business. And we will be here same time next week, but a different location. So make sure to tune in next Monday at 11 o'clock. Have an amazing day.
See you guys. Bye.
Bye.